Hello everyone, welcome to Tangle with Tracy Anne. In this week's video, I'll be exploring the beautiful art of Mehndi. You normally see these henna tattoos on bodies, but the patterns lend themselves really well to Zentangle. So I've played around and come up with a few bookmarks, quite a few bookmarks. Too many for one video, so I've split them into 2 weeks. So join me this week and next week to make some beautiful bookmarks. Before we begin, I'll show you some of the elements that I'll be using in my designs today. So we'll start off with dots of all kinds of sizes. Straight lines, and they can be thin or they can be thick. Scallops, they can be close together, further apart, big, small. Swirls, so there's our print tops, or they can be big or even have a fescue shape. Then we have some petal shapes because flowers are common. And leaf shapes, so it can be like a normal sort of leaf with veins, or when they use henna, it's a thick paste, so you get variations in thickness. We can't do that with a micron, but we can draw the shape as if it was thick. So we put these elements together and we can make flowers, or we can make mandalas. And these are just building up of patterns. Adding auras is also a common technique. You can also build up these patterns in a free form sort of a way, or start with a line and have them going in a linear fashion. I've cut some of my bookmarks out of this tanned mixed media paper. It's 6 by 8 inches, so I can get 3 out of it, 2 inch wide by 8 inch long. I've just marked quarter sections down each side of this just to get an even distribution. And I'm placing a dot right in the center of each of those quarter sections, and that's going to be the center of each flower. Now I'm going to join each of these flowers with a bit of a swirl. And that one's gone a little bit wonky, but it won't matter in the scheme of things. If you ever make little lines that shouldn't be there, one quick fix is to just add another row of gold, and that covers that little line up quite nicely. I might put a little bit more of that gold in the center of the flowers just to balance it out a little bit more. Add a little bit of shading.
the gold doesn't really stand out in the center, so I'm going to touch it up a little bit with black pen. Here's another bookmark that I completed. The flowers are a little bit smaller and I added some white charcoal pencil. You can see where the tip of those petals are white. Now you can decide whether to leave that white off or add it, but I'll just add it on this and see what it looks like. Thank you. Because I have some space in the centre of this bookmark, I can add some writing, a name or a quote. And if you're not confident at doing your own handwriting, here's a little tip for you. Design what you're going to say first of all on a computer or iPad and then print it out. Cut it so that it fits and make sure it's where you want it to go. Then on the back of it, just colour with the white charcoal pencil. Because I'm doing this on a black bookmark, I'm using white charcoal pencil. If you were using a white bookmark, just do it with a normal graphite pencil. So now that I've placed it where I want it to go, I'm just going to trace that lettering. I'm doing this using a normal ballpoint pen. Once the gold pen is completely dry, you can brush away that white dust a little bit with a paintbrush, or if it's quite stubborn, use an eraser. Here's another one I did earlier. I just wrote that myself without tracing it, but you can see it's not quite centered properly. And I added some touches of white gel pen to make the gold stand out. So this is up to you if you want to do that. I'll just show you how I did that. I didn't want to put the white gel pen in every area, just in sections to highlight the gold a little bit. Thank you.
I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't already subscribed to my YouTube channel, do that so that you don't miss out on future videos. Thank you for watching, and until next week, stay safe and bye for now. If you'd like to see more of my videos, head over to my YouTube channel, or there are a couple of links here on the screen, and there's the subscribe button.